So let me show you how this template is organized. This template basically has five sections. A summary table where I can see a very high level overview of my finances for the month. Then I have a balance sheet where I can see month by month a breakdown on how my finances are progressing. Then I have the core of this template, which are the monthly expense tracker and the monthly income tracker. And finally, at the very bottom, I do have some detailed overviews to see per category and per month how much I'm spending. Finally, you can see at the very bottom the actual databases that are running this template, because actually everything that you see in this page are just views of that database. But let me now show you in detail how this template works so you can also use it. So what you can see at the top is the balance database, and this one is essentially a relational database, which means that I do not have to input anything myself, but it's just gathering data from other databases to create these overviews. And here, basically, I can see month by month what has been my income for the month, my expenses, how much I have saved, both in absolute value, but also as a percentage of my income, and then also how much did I spend on things that I need and on things that I want. And the reason why I have this split between saving, needs, and wants is because I try to follow a very common budgeting strategy, which you might have seen as the 50-30-20 budgeting rule. And essentially, this technique says that you should not allocate more than 50% of your income to expenses that you need. And that would be, for example, like paying for your rent or paying for your utilities, gas, electricity, and so on. Then you should allocate no more than 30% of your budget to things that you want. And that would be, for example, your Netflix subscription, going to the gym, shopping, going to the cinema, all those activities that you spend money on but you don't actually really need to spend money on. And finally, the remaining 20% you should save so that you can invest it in other assets that would generate money for you further down the line. Now, in my case, I'm a bit more aggressive in the saving. I thought 20% is a bit conservative, so I went for 30%. And that's why if you look at this database, you can see that whenever I'm below that 30%, you have this red cross over here, whereas when I'm above it, meaning I am meeting my target, you have this nice green tick to remind you that you achieve your goal. Now, moving on, you can see below the actual backbone of this template. And these are the monthly expense tracker and the monthly income tracker. And maybe let me show you how the actual database looks like, and then I can deep dive into these views. So here you can see the expense database, and you can see that I'm tracking several items like the year when this expense happened, the month, but also a brief description on what this expense is about, then how much money did I spend on that. Then I also like to add a category so I can track where I'm spending my money, if it's in food, if it's in subscriptions, transportation, or something else. I also have a column to check if that expense is something fixed and that every month I will have to pay the same, or if it's something flexible and it can vary month over month. And finally, I can also label whether that expense is something that I need or something that I want, so then I can track it back in the balance database, how much I'm spending actually in things that I need and how much in things that I want. Now, of course, if every time you would have an expense, you would have to fill in all this data, it would create quite a lot of friction and probably it would mean that you would not be doing that step of inputting the expense. So in this case, the way this template works is that here in the monthly expense tracker, I actually have a filtered view of that database where I already filter by the current year and the current month. So then whenever I have a new expense and I want to input that either on my phone or on my laptop, I just need to go here, I click to new, and as you can see, it already comes with some of the data pre-filtered, so I only need to introduce what this expense is about, how much I spend, quick category, and whether it's a need or want. And then next to it, I also have the monthly income tracker. And this works in the exact same way. It's also a filtered view of the actual database. And here I also input any sort of income that is reaching my account, like my monthly salary, but also if there are any refunds that I'm receiving, maybe I make money that month out of my side hustles, then it would also go in here with the correct category. And I also like to track from that income how much I should save to meet that target of 30%. Now, next to these monthly trackers, you have this magic button that it really saves me a lot of time. There are some expenses, of course, that are like the same month over month. Let's say, for example, your rent, subscriptions, and the same goes for income. You probably have the same salary every month. There is this magic button that you just need to click it, and it automatically generates all the recurring expenses that I have every month. So then when a new month starts, I just need to select all these expenses, I drag them into the database, and they are already pre-filled with the right year and the right month, which saves you a lot of time. And then finally, the feature that really helped me to going from saving almost no money, like you could see in my balance database, to saving more than 30% of my salary is actually what you see over here. And here, basically, I created some detailed overviews of my expenses, and let me quickly explain you how they work. So on the left side, you have a very simple overview, but also very useful, in which basically you can see how much money you are expending per category. So here, with just a quick glance, you can see where most of your money is going, and that's probably also where most of the money can be saved. And then next to this, on the right side, I have a budget breakdown. And the way this works is that basically for every month, I can see a few categories like food, transportation, eating out, leisure shopping. And for each of these categories, you can assign a budget. And then you can quickly track how much you are spending per category and whether you are going within the budget or over the budget. And this, in my case, it really helped me, because if you see how much I used to spend in the past in transportation, basically I was always over budget. And basically what I figured out is that I was being quite lazy and using Uber more than I should. So this was a clear place where I could cut my expenses and increase my savings. And for me, the nice thing of this breakdown is that in a very quick glance, you can see every month if you are spending over budget or if you are staying within the budget for these categories. And then of course, if there is a certain category where you are consistently not managing to stay within your budget, you can deep dive more into it and try to see where you should be cutting your expenses to stay within the budget. So like I mentioned, this template really helped me to drastically increase my savings, like you have seen. And I really hope it can also help you to achieve your financial goals. Therefore, what I'm gonna be doing is that I'll be sharing for free this template to anybody who subscribes to my newsletter. You can find the link in the description below. And yeah, let me know in the comments below if you have used the template and if it really works for you. And in general, if you got any value from this video, please drop a like and I'll see you next time. Bye.